this is Josh Taylor with TradeAdvisor Pro, and I want to thank you for checking out our video today. Now, before we get started with today's free Forex training video, I want to give you a chance to pause this video right now and go to our website. TradeAdvisor Pro offers you free Forex training, free Forex training videos, and trade alerts. And folks, you do not want to miss our trade alerts. We send out a bunch of trade alerts every month that are top rated in the industry, where we send you our exact trades right to your inbox. Pause the video now, go to tradeadvisorpro.com/free, and all you have to do is register, and then come back to this video, and we'll be sending a lot more goodies to help you with your Forex trading. Enjoy today's training video. Let's talk about risk. Now, using the example I just gave you before, 2% per trade is the maximum you should risk. In fact, that's a guideline that I use. I rarely ever trade more than 1 to 1.2% per trade, because my account balances are most likely larger than the majority of the people watching this video course. I am not really interested in losing 10% of my account balance. 10% of my account balance is vast. It is well into the six figures, and I'm really not interested in losing that kind of money. And so, you know, my trading accounts are more for long-term approach. They're creating and building wealth, and therefore the gambler in me, the mentality of I have to double my account every 3 months, is not there. I'm thinking more like an investor. So 1% per trade is fine, because if I do lose 3 to 5 trades in a row, I can handle 3 to 5% loss on my accounts. Now, for me, 2% per trade, and I lose 3 to 5, that's 10% of my account balance. To me, that's risky, that's scary to me, so that I don't do that. So for me, it's 1%. I would suggest for you, no more than 2%. I know some people that do 3-4% per trade. You know, if you have a smaller account, it's probably fine, but my suggestion is 2. I also suggest that you don't risk more than 5% of all your trades. So if you're going to do 1% per trade, 2% per trade, but you're going to be in 5 trades, then I suggest you cut them all down to 1%, so that if a huge market move happens, you don't get stuck in 10 different losing trades. Okay, you might be stuck in 5 different losing trades at 10% risk. You only want to risk 5%. So, and it also, here's a big key. This is what I'll talk about when I talked about how I had lost 10 trades in a row. So this is how I added this to my game plan. No more than 2 like-minded pairs. Now let me show you this example. So in this example, I'm showing 4 currency pairs: the euro dollar, the euro yen, the euro Aussie, and the euro pound. Now, these are all like-minded in the fact that they all have the euro in them. Okay. Now let's say that I'm in 4 different euro positions. All 4 of these trades I'm in at once. And then out of nowhere, in the eurozone, a huge market announcement comes out about the euro is going, you know, the eurozone might has bankruptcy potential sitting on the verge, and, you know, some country's going bankrupt or something along that line. The euro is going to drop so significantly that you could very easily get stopped out of 4 trades at once. So what happened is because you were in 4 different euro trades, you're putting too much risk by putting everything you've got into the euro. So I'm going to suggest no more than 2 like-minded pairs. Even if you see 4 amazing trade setups, choose the 2 top ones. You know, if the euro dollar and the euro yen are the 2 top trades, take those 2 trades. But don't take more than 2 like-minded pairs. Now let me explain why I added this to my plan. I told you earlier in this video that one of my mentors who coached me on how to trade at the very beginning told me that even the best traders are going to lose 10 trades in a row at some point in their life. I had never done that. In fact, at the time shooting this video, I've been trading now for 8 years. I've never lost more than 5 trades in a row, ever. But in October of 2012, which is approximately 4 months ago, I had set up a tremendous number of trade setups that were just looking really great. The trend on the euro and the pound were both up. So I took I set five pending orders on the euro and five pending orders on the pound. Now these are all different cross pairs, like euro dollar, euro yen, euro pound, euro Aussie. I forget what the other one was. And then I also chose five trades that were on the pound. Now the euro and the pound are very correlated, okay? So I really had 10 trades that were very like-minded. And sure enough, a big announcement came out. I think it was that the Eurozone was going to be selling off an unlimited amount of debt instruments, which I forget what exactly it was. I'm just trying to guess offhand. Something that caused the euro to go nuts. Now, here's the deal. The market was up. I was looking for these pairs to pull down, to drop, or what's called a retracement, to take us into an entry and then shoot up over a period of time. And because I set all 10 of these trades, I figured within the next day or so, we might hit two or three of them. But what happened is the market moved down so abruptly that all 10 of those trades hit, and within a day and a half, they were all stopped out. I lost 10 trades in a row. Now, so immediately I went back to my equity management plan. And I made a commitment that I will not trade more than two like-minded pairs. For example, you see on the screen the euro yen. Now, right now, at the time of this video, the yen cross pairs, pound yen, euro yen, Swiss yen, Aussie yen, dollar yen, have been shooting up. In fact, the euro yen's gone almost up 3,000 pips in the last 5 months. So, knowing that, even though these pairs are trending up strongly, even though, and we've been trading a lot of yen cross pairs, waiting for a drop down to take us an entry to shoot back up. We'll talk more about that later. I made a commitment to myself to only take two trades. So I've been trading a lot of the euro yen and the dollar yen. Have traded very well. In fact, over the last 3 weeks, I've won every single one of those trades. A couple of days ago, I took one on the Aussie yen. So the point I'm trying to make is if I took five yen-based trades, and all of a sudden some news comes out that causes the yen to strengthen tremendously, it could reverse all of these trades and I could be stopped out on all five of them. I'm willing to be stopped out in one or two, but five in a row, that pushes me beyond my emotional point. Okay? And so going back to what we talked about, 2% risk maximum per trade. 5% max risk at once across all your trades is what I suggest, and no more than two like-minded pairs at once. Very, very important. Folks, I hope you enjoyed today's training video. If you have not done so already, stop this video now and go to tradeadvisorpro.com/free and register absolutely free for free Forex training, free Forex training videos, and free Forex traded alerts directly to your inbox. Go to the website right now and register for free. All kinds of goodies for you. Thanks a lot.